In this video, we are going to see crashing of project network. See, generally in any project network, the first step is determine the critical path with a normal activity timing. Okay, then when we execute the activity, we can speed up the activity timing in order to reduce the total completion time of a particular project network. So this is called as crashing of project network. Now let us understand this concept along with the problem in detail. Look at the problem. Consider the data of a project as shown in the following table. Here the problem is there, that is activity, different activities are there, normal duration, that is in weeks is given for each and every activity, and normal cost, the cost involved for the each and every activity also given in this column. And the next one is crash time. Okay, when we speed up the activity, the same activity can be complete within 4 weeks. Okay, this one is normal time and this one is crash time. Okay, and this one is crash cost. So generally when we speed up the activity, cost will be higher when compared to normal cost. See, normal cost 700, the crash cost is 850. Okay, so when we crash the activity, the cost will be increased, that is greater than the normal cost, whereas the crash time will be lesser than the normal timing. So this is the information given in this table. See, if the indirect cost per week is 200 rupees, find the optimal crashed project completion time. See, according to this problem, indirect cost per week how much? 200 rupees. So with this information, we are going to solve the problem for crashing of project network. See, before you draw the network diagram, first thing you need to find the slope for all the activities. Okay, so there is a formula to find out this slope. The formula is crash cost minus normal cost divided by normal time minus crash time. Slope is equal to crash cost minus normal cost divided by normal time minus crash time. With the help of this formula, you can find out the slope for all the activities. For the first activity, the crash cost is 850, normal cost is 700. Crash cost is 850, normal cost is 700 divided by normal time minus crash time. Normal time 7 weeks, crash time 4 weeks. So 7 minus 4. Okay, so what is the difference? 850 minus 700, 150 divided by 7 minus 4. 3. The answer is 50. So this is slope. Okay, the same way you have to find out the slope for each and every activity. Apply this formula and find out slope. For the first activity, slope is 50. For the second activity, 100, 100 and 350. Okay, these are the values for slope. Okay, and after finding the slope, now we can proceed further. This is the network diagram for the given activities. Okay, the first activity, node 1 to 2, and its duration is 7 weeks. Okay, the second activity, node 1 to 3, its duration is 5 weeks. And the third activity, node 1 to 4, and its duration is 8 weeks. And the fourth activity, node 2 to 5, its duration is 9 weeks. And the next activity, node 3 to 5, its duration is 5 weeks. And the next activity, node 3 to 6, and its duration is 6 weeks. And the next activity, node 4 to 6, and its duration is 7 weeks. The next activity is node 5 to 7, and its duration is 2 weeks. And the last activity, node 6 to 7, and its duration is 3 weeks. Okay, so this is the way to draw the network diagram under normal condition. Okay, now we'll move on to the next procedure. See, after drawing the network diagram, the next step is you need to find the critical path. Critical path means the maximum completion time is called critical path. In order to find out the critical path, just list out the what are the various possible ways to complete the task. See, the first possibility, 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. And write the duration. Here, in order to complete the first activity, duration is 7. So 1 to 2, 7, 2 to 5, 9, 5 to 7, 2. Just add the duration. 7 plus 9 plus 2 is equal to 18. Okay, the project completion time is 18 in this particular way. Now find out the other possibilities. See the other possibility, 1 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 7. The duration, total completion time is 5 plus 5 plus 2. Okay, is equal to 12. 5 plus 5 plus 2 is equal to 12. Okay, now find out the other possibility. 1 to 3, 3 to 6 and 6 to 7. This is the third possibility. 1 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 7. Now write the duration. So 1 to 3, 5, 3 to 6, 6, 6 to 7, 3. So total 5 plus 6 plus 3. 5 plus 6 plus 3 is equal to 14. Okay. And the last possibility is 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. Right? 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. Okay. Now find out the duration. 1 to 4, 8. 4 to 6, 7. 6 to 7, 3. So 8 plus 7 plus 3. 8 plus 7 plus 3 is equal to 18. Okay, among these possibilities, you need to find the critical path. Here we have got two values equal, no? So 18 and 18. So in this network, we have got two critical paths. Critical path means the maximum duration is called critical path. So this one is critical path, as well as this is also critical path. Okay, we have got two critical path. Okay, so this is the second step. The first step is you need to draw the network diagram, and second step you need to find out the critical path. According to this problem, we have got two critical paths. The first one is 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Right? 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. This is the critical path, and one more critical path is also there, that is 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. The second critical path is 1 to 4 and 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. See, the highest completion time is 18. So this is the normal project completion time. Okay, so right here, normal project completion time is 18 weeks. Okay, and the critical paths are 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Okay, and the second critical path is 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. So 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. These are the two critical paths, and the total cost is, see, look at the problem. Just find the total of normal cost column. Okay, find the total. The total amount is 6,500. This is the total direct normal cost. Okay, 6,500. See, the total direct normal cost is given in the table. Okay, how much? 6,500. Now you have to add the indirect cost. Look at the problem. The indirect cost, how much? If the indirect cost per week is 200, okay, so per week how much? 200 rupees, no. So total completion duration is 18 weeks. Now multiply 200 with 18. So total direct cost how much? 6,500. Now add the indirect cost. 200 into 18, 3,600. How much total cost? 10,100. Okay, this is the total cost for the normal completion time. So the normal project completion time is 18 weeks, and we have got two critical paths. The total direct normal cost, which is given in the problem, and indirect cost, how much? 200 rupees per week. So total completion duration is 18 weeks. No. So 200 into 18, 3,600. Now the total cost, how much? 10,100. This is the way to calculate total cost for normal duration. Now we are going to crashing the network to reduce the project completion time. Okay. In order to perform the crashing, the next step is we need to find the crash limit and slope. Okay, for the given critical path. So in this problem, we have got two critical paths. No. So write down the critical path and write the critical activity of the critical path. And you need to find the crash limit for those activities. And we need to take the slope of those critical activities. Okay. Now, crash limit means the difference between crash time and normal time. time for the given critical activity. In the same way, we need to take the slope. I have already explained you know how to find out slope. From there, you have to take the slope, cost of slope for the given critical activities. Okay, now let me write the critical path. Here we have got two critical paths. No, first one is 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Write here 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Here you need to write the critical activities separately. That is 1 to 2 and 2 to 5 and finally 5 to 7 separately. Now you need to find the crash limit for those activities. For first activity, that is from 1 to 2, what is the crash limit? For that, just see the difference between crash time and normal time of this particular activity. That is 1 to 2. Look at the problem. In order to find out the crash limit for this particular activity, just compare the normal time with the crash time. 7 and 4. What is the difference? 3. Just write 3. In the same way, you need to find crash limit for 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Look at the problem. For 2 to 5, the crash limit is 9 minus 7. 2. 2. For the last one, 5 to 7. No. Look at the problem. For 5 to 7, normal time is 2, crash time is 1. Difference 1. 1. Okay. Now you need to write the slope for these activities. Okay. Look at the solution and find out the slope for 1 to 2 and 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Look at the problem. Okay, 1 to 2, slope is 50. This we have found based on the formula, no? So from here, you can write the slope directly. So for 1 to 2, slope is 50 rupees. Right here, 50. In the same way, you have to find the slope for the these two activities. That is 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. 2 to 5, 225. 5 to 7, 100. 225 and 100. In the same way, you need to write these things for the second critical path. That is 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. Critical activity 1 to 4, then 4 to 6, then 6 to 7. So these are the three critical activities. Now you need to find the crash limit for 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. Look at the problem. For 1 to 4, normal time is 8. Crash time is 5. What is the difference? 3. Okay. And the next one, 4 to 6, normal time is 7 and crash time is 5. Difference 2. And the last one, 6 to 7. So for activity 6 to 7, normal time is 3 and crash time is 2. Difference 1. Right here, 3, 2 and 1. And the same way, you have to write this slope for these activities. For activity 1 to 4, slope is 200. And the next one, activity 4 to 6, the slope is 125. And the last one, activity 6 to 7, slope is 350. 200, 125 and 350. After finding these things, the next step is you need to find the least slope value among all other values in the first critical path. In these three activities, the slope is 50. 225 and 100. So out of these three values, 50 is the least value. No. So select this particular activity. In the same way, find out the least slope cost in the second critical path. So which one is least? 125 is the least. So I'm going to select this one. Okay. See, out of these values, this is the least value, no? So I'm going to crash this particular activity by 1 week. This will lead to increase 50 rupees extra cost. Okay. In the same way, in the second critical path, I'm going to crash this particular activity by 1 week. Okay. So this will lead to increase 125 rupees extra. I'm going to crash this particular activity by reducing 1 week. Okay. That is 1, 2. Look at the diagram. The duration is for 1, 2, duration is 7, no. So I'm going to reduce 1, so it will be 6. In the same way, in the second critical path, I'm going to crash this one, that is 4, 6, no. Here I'm going to reduce 1 week. So in the 4, 6, 7 is there, no, 7 weeks. So I'm going to reduce 1, so it will be 6 weeks. So with this, I'm going to draw the second iteration. In the second iteration, I'm going to reduce 1, in this activity. In the same way, I'm going to reduce 1 week in this duration. Okay. All other things remain same. In the second iteration, for the first activity, duration is 6. Here, 5 as it is, 8 as it is, 9 as it is, 5, 6, 2, 3. Here also we have reduced 1 now. So instead of 7, you have to write 6. So now you have to find out the critical path again. So what are the possibilities are there? The possibilities are 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Duration is 6 plus 9, 9 plus 2. 6 plus 9, 9 plus 2 is equal to 17 weeks. The second possibility, 1 to 3, 3 to 5 and 5 to 7. Duration is 5 plus 5 plus 2 is equal to 12. Okay, third possibility is 1 to 3, 3 to 6 and 6 to 7. Duration is 5 plus 6 plus 3 is equal to 14. Okay, the last possibility is 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. Duration is 8 plus 6 plus 3, 17. Again, we have got two critical paths. The highest value is, the highest duration is 17 and 17. We have two critical paths. Okay, the first critical path is 1 to 2 and 2 to 5 and then 5 to 7. The second critical path is 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. These are the two critical paths. After finding the critical path, now write down the total project completion time. Okay, the project completion time is 17 weeks. Okay, and critical paths are 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. And the second one, 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. These are the two critical paths. The next step is just take the first iteration total cost. Okay. And add the extra cost because we have reduced 1 week now. Okay. So this will lead to increase the direct cost and this will lead to decrease the indirect cost. Okay. In the first iteration, the total project completion time was 18 weeks now. Now it reduced to 17 weeks. So 1 week reduced now. So for that, it will lead to increase for that one particular week. This will lead to increase the direct cost. Okay, and this will lead to decrease the indirect cost. So indirect cost per week, how much? 200 rupees. This is given in the problem itself. Okay, for per week, how much indirect expense? 200 rupees. Okay, so this will lead to decrease the indirect expense. At the same time, this will lead to increase the direct expense. So direct expense, how much? Look at the table. See, when we crash these two activities, this will lead to increase the cost. Okay, for the first activity, 50 rupees. For this activity, 125 rupees. Total 175 rupees. So when you crash the network, this will lead to increased direct expense. At the same time, this will lead to decrease the indirect expense. How much direct expense? 50 plus 125, 175. Now take the first iteration total expense. How much? 10,100 and add direct expense, that is 50 plus 125, and subtract 200 rupees, that is indirect expense per week. Take the previous value, total cost how much? 10,100 plus direct expense. How much? 50 plus 125. Okay, add direct expense and subtract indirect expense. So you'll be getting 10,075. Now, okay, after crashing the network by 1 week, the total cost how much? 10,075. So this total cost is lesser than the previous one. So previously it was 10,100. Okay, after crashing by 1 week, okay, the total cost is 10,075 rupees. This is lesser than the previous one. This is the way to calculate total cost after crashing the network. Now you need to move further in order to minimize the total cost. Okay, let me go for the third iteration. As we did previously, in the same way, find out the crash limit and slope for the critical path. Okay, here we have two critical paths now. The first one, 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. Critical activity, 1 to 2, then 2 to 5 and the last one 5 to 7. In the same way, the second critical path is 1 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 7. No, write the critical activity 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. Now, write the crash limit. So already we crashed the first activity. No, now we have to reduce 1 week and you have to take the remaining value. See the previous table. Look at the previous table. See, the critical path remains same. No, just copy the same thing and here we reduced 1 week. No, okay, so now it will be 2 and here we have reduced 1 week. No, so it will be 1. Okay, all other things remain same. Crash limit is 3 minus 1, 2, 2, 1. 3, 2 minus 1, 1, 1, 50, 225, 100, 200, 125 and 350, 2, 1, okay here, 3, 1, 1, slope will be remain same, just copy the previous one, 50, 225, 100, 200, 125 and 350. Now, you need to find out the least value. So, in the first critical path, 50 is the least slope. No. So, now I am going to crash this particular activity. Again, I am going to select the same thing. Why? Because among these three values, 50 is the least value. No. So, I am going to crash this particular activity by reducing 1 week. Okay. In the same way, in the second critical path, 125 is the least value. No. So, here I am going to reduce 1 week. Already 1 week is there. I am going to reduce this. Okay. So, it will be 0 in the next table. Now, I am going to reduce 1 week in this particular activity. In the same way, I am going to reduce 1 week in this particular activity. Okay, now I am going to draw the third iteration. Look at the second iteration. In the first critical path, I am going to reduce 1 week in this particular duration. In the same way, in the second critical path, I am going to reduce 1 week in this particular activity. So, all other values remain same. In the third iteration, all other durations are remain same. Only we have reduced in this particular activity for the first critical path and here we have reduced in the second critical path. Okay, now you need to find the critical path again. Okay, what are the possibilities? 1, 2, 5, 7. Okay, the duration is 5 plus 9 plus 2, 16. Second one, 1, 3, 5, 7. Duration is 5 plus 5 plus 2, 12. The third one is 1, 3, 6, 7. Duration is 5 plus 6 plus 3, 14. And the last one, 1, 4, 6, 7. Duration is 8 plus 5 plus 3, 16. Again, we have got the same critical path. That is 16 and 16. These are the two critical paths. The total project completion time is 16 weeks. Okay, here write down. Project completion time is 16 weeks. Now, take the total cost of the previous iteration and add direct expense and subtract indirect expense. Okay. See the previous iteration total cost how much? 10,075. No. Take this value. 10,075 and add additional cost incurred by reducing 1 week. Okay. So, previously it was 17 weeks. No. So, here 16 weeks. So, 1 week reduced. For that, you need to incur additional expense. Additional expense how much? 50 rupees plus 125 rupees. 50 rupees plus 125 and this will lead to reduce indirect cost. How much? 200 rupees no per week. Subtract 200 rupees. In the third iteration, the total cost how much? 10,050 rupees. Now compare this value. Previously it was 10,075. No. In the third iteration, the total cost is 10,050. This amount is lesser than the previous one. So now we can move further in order to find out the least total cost. Okay. In order to crash one more week, you need to find the crash limit and slope. See, in this stage also, we have got the same critical path. So you can copy crash limit from the previous table. Look at the previous table. For the first one, we have reduced 1. No. So, it will be 1. For second one, 2. The third one, 1 only. Okay. In the second critical path, okay, this will be the same. 3 as it is. For here, we have reduced 1. No. This will be 0. And the third one, 1. 1, 2, 1, 3, 0, 1. Slope will be remain same. 50, 225, and 100 for the second critical path, 200, 125, 350. Okay, out of these things, which one is least value? Again, 50 is the least value. In the second critical path, 125 is the least value, but we cannot crash this because maximum we crashed. So here the crash limit is 0. You cannot crash anymore. So you cannot take this value. What is the next least value? 200 is the least value. So now you can take this one. Okay, so now I am going to crash by 1 week in this particular activity. In the second critical path, I am going to reduce 1 week in this particular activity. That is in 1-4, I am going to reduce 1. Okay, in the same way, in activity 1-2, I am going to reduce 1. See the diagram? In 1-2, in this particular activity, duration is 5 weeks. No, so I am going to reduce 1 week. So it will be 4. In the second critical path, I am going to reduce 1 week in this particular activity, that is 1-4. 1-4, it was 8. I am going to reduce 1 week. So it will be 7 in the fourth iteration. In the fourth iteration, this will be 4 and this will be 7. All other duration value remain same. Now I am going to draw the fourth iteration. I have taken the value from the previous iteration and except these two values. Okay, I have reduced 1 week here and here also I have reduced 1 week. Now you need to find the critical paths again. The four possibilities are 1-2, 2-5, 5-7. Duration is 4+9+2 is equal to 15 weeks. The second possibility is 1-3, 3-5. 5-7, duration is 5+5+2 is equal to 12 weeks. The third possibility is 1-3, 3-6, 6-7, duration is 5+6+3 is equal to 14 weeks. The last possibility is 1-4, 4-6 and 6-7, duration is 7+5+3 is equal to 15 weeks. Again, we have got two critical paths. Okay, equal value. No. So, same critical path is there. After finding the critical path, now the total project completion time is 15 weeks. Okay, and the critical paths are 1-2-5-7 and 1-4-6-7. These are the two critical paths. Now you have to find out the total cost. For that, now take the previous iteration total cost and add the direct cost and minus the indirect cost. Look at the previous iteration total cost, 10,050 rupees. Take 10,050 rupees and add direct cost for the activity. How much we have taken? 50+200. So totally 250. And minus indirect cost. Indirect cost how much? 200. No. So what is the total cost? 10,100. Okay. This is the total cost after crashing by 1 week. Okay. See, in the fourth iteration, we have got 10,100. No. This value is greater than the previous iteration cost. So stop the procedure. Consider the previous iteration value is the optimum value. Now we can conclude the problem by stating that since the total cost of this iteration is, that is the fourth iteration is more than that of the previous iteration. So stop the procedure and treat the previous iteration, that is third iteration solution, as the best solution for implementation. So the final crashed project completion time is 16 weeks and the corresponding critical paths are 1-2, 2-5 and 5-7 and the second critical path is 1-4, 4-6 and 6-7. Hope you all understood this concept. Thank you.